In this video tutorial, I will show you how to create an HTML form and also how to use PHP to handle all the data from the HTML form and to validate that data. So, let's do it. Hey, what's up guys? Senaid here from codingpassiveincome.com, the place where I help others to become a web developer much easier and faster than they will do it on their own. So, if that is something that interests you, consider subscribing. So, before we even start with this tutorial, like always, I want to explain the basics that you need to understand. So, first, I will show you how to create an HTML form, just quickly the basics, and then we will move to the PHP. So let's say we want to create some contact form, so we'll have one input, let's say name, email, some body of this email and some submit button. Now in order to create this HTML form, to write it in HTML we will say form, and now we need to specify the method how we will send the data from this HTML form to the PHP. And now this is important step. So for example, I will say method equal post, or this can be get. So we'll use post or get, and we need to specify the action, which means where the data will be sent. So for example, I will say index .php. For example, that is the name of some of our files. We will close this, and of course we need to close this tag. So let's say here I will close the form. And now to create this input name, we will say input, and we need to specify the name of this input so that we can recognize it later. So for example, we will say name equal username, and the type of this input could be the text. Okay, now the same thing is with the email. We will just say for example input name equal email, type we can say it is email. And the last thing is this text area. So this is text area. We can also use the input here, but the input will just limit the number of characters we can enter visually. So we can enter as many as we want, but we can't see all of them. So it's better to use text area because it's visually looking bigger and it feels like we can enter more characters. So I will say text area, and I will just specify the some name. So for example, I will say body. And for the text area, we don't need to specify the type. Okay, and we will just close this text area. And now the last thing is this submit button. So we will just say input type submit, okay, and name we can say submit, and value we can say send email, okay, and we'll close. So this is just how to create this HTML form. But now what is important is how to handle the data inside PHP from this form. So let's say we have here some PHP code. So now when we have decided here on which method we are using, it will decide how we are going to accept the information in PHP. So for example, if we want to accept from this input username, we will say for example, we will create variable name equal, and now since our method is post, we will say dollar sign post, and here we are going to specify this name. So we will say just user name. Okay, and that's it. Now inside this variable name, we have stored whatever the visitor has entered here. And the same thing applies to the email, body, etc. And like I said, the only difference is if we use the get method. So instead of this post, we will just say $get, and here we will specify just the name of our input or text area. So for example, we'll say here email, but this is not valid right now because our method is post at the moment. So this is just the basics on how to create the HTML form and how to send and accept the data inside PHP. So let me now just use my PC to actually show you how to write the code and also how to accept the informations and validate all those inputs. So now I'm here at my PHP store and I have created an M2 project called PHP Forms, and I have created an M2 index.php file. Also, I have started my XAMPP server, so that is what you need to do too. So first thing that we are going to do, like I showed on my whiteboard, is to create an HTML form. So I will just declare normal HTML document. I will create head, and inside head I will just have title. Let's say PHP Forms, and I will have body, and in the body we will create form. So I will say form method, I will use post, action, I will use the same file which is index.php, and I'm going to close this tag. Inside here I'm going to create few inputs. So first input will be type text, name, username, and let's say I will use placeholder, we will say just name. So basically placeholder is what the visitor will see and how he will know what he is going to enter there. So let me just show you. So as you can see here, we have only one input and the placeholder is name, and now when we start typing it will disappear, and if we delete everything it will show name, and in that way basically we just know what we need to enter there. Anyway, I will insert one break and create a new input. So I will say type email, name email, and I will say placeholder email. Also, I'm going to create one text area, name body, and I'll just close it. And the last thing is one submit button. So I'll say type submit, name submit. Name is always optional, so it's all on you how you will give it a name. This is what I usually do. And value, I will set send email. So let's now check what we have. So we got name, email, and as you can see, we don't have placeholder for the body. So we will say placeholder message. And here we are. And when I talked about the difference between inputs and text area, now we can see it. Basically, we can grab this here and resize this message, and with the input we can do that. So visually text area is much bigger and we just have feeling that we can enter more data inside there. Now once we have created this form, we need to write the PHP code that will handle this data and also that will validate. So I will at the top of this file write PHP tags and say if isset post submit. So what does it mean? If someone is pressed this button send email, we will detect it by using function isset, and also we are using post here because our method is post. And now we can just store the informations that we start entered into some variable. So we'll say name equal post username, and we can do the same thing with email. And with message, and our post for the message is body. So as you can see here, name is body, and because of that we are using here body. So now we need to validate this data. So how we are going to do it, all depends on what you really want to accomplish with that form. So let's say in this example I want that each and every name must be longer than 3 characters. So I will do that by checking the length of what visitor entered. So I can use the function from the PHP string length and pass the variable name, and this function will return the length of this string. So we can say if string length less than 3, we can say echo name, you can say just please check your name. Okay, now we can test that. So if we just press send email, it will say please check your name, and if we enter something longer than 3 characters, we can say send email, and as you can see there isn't any message, which means everything is looking good. For the email, we can say we can use the function filter variables. Basically, it will just do some basic checkings of the email. So we can say if not filter variable email filter validate email echo please check your email. So this function will return true or false, and how we use it, basically as the first parameter we are passing our email that visitor entered, and filter type we just say filter validate email. So we have different filters on for this function, and I'm using the one that is made only for the email. So we can test this too. I will refresh. Let's say email name is longer, and now let's say I will write an email that shouldn't be correct. So I will say something like this. And now if you try to send email, it's looking good. But if we try like this, it says please check your email, because we cannot create an email that is starting with a full stop. So once again, some email, and let's say like this, send email, and the result is the same. And if we have correct email, for example, send email, as you can see, everything is looking good. So this part is working too. And the last thing that we need to check is, for example, the length of our body message. So we can use the same function as we did for a name. So we can say else if string length message less than, for example, 10 characters, we can say echo please check your, or message is too short. Else we can say echo your data is looking good, sending an email. And now we don't have a code that we use for sending an email. And if you are interested in that, I have another tutorial called PHP Mailer. So if you want to learn how to send an email to, just use that one. So let's test this functionality. Name should be good. And now let's test the message. It says message is too short. And let's now say I will put some good informations. My real name, email. This is my message. And I hope you will like it. Just something long and hit send email. Now it says your data is looking good, sending an email. So if you want to make it a little bit nicer, we can define some and apply some styles. So for example, we'll say here message is an empty, and instead of each echo, we will say message equal, should do it here too. And we can use a font to apply some style, even that is deprecated, so we should only use CSS, but just for the purpose of this tutorial, I want to show you how to do it. Color, let's say red. Okay, and here we will close it. Okay, and down below we will say here. Here I will say green, and I will also close it here. And we can display the message, for example, under this form. So I can say PHP echo message. Okay, and let's test now. So as you can see, now it is looking much better. And if we try to make something wrong, it will say now message is too short. Otherwise it was everything good. Anyway, so this is just the basic tutorial on how to use the PHP forms. I hope you like it. If you do, please like it and share it to your friends. And also, if there is anything that you don't understand or there is something that you want to ask, I will be sure to check all the comments below and also answer all of them. Take care.